By October, the land is frozen solid. Two polar bear cubs have survived the summer thanks to their mother. The sea won't freeze solid until November, but some coastal bays and river estuaries freeze earlier. It's their playground while they wait. On warm days, the surface starts to melt and become slippery, and tides weaken the new ice. The surface is still fragile. By midwinter, they'll be sniffing out seals in a freezing twilight far from land. This is their Ice Age home at last. A timeless scene that leaves behind a world of change. Then the ice breaks, and reality returns. The sea melts and refreezes and will melt again for two frustrating months. The polar bears of the southern Beaufort Sea are doing better than many others around the Arctic. The Arctic National Wildlife Refuge protects the dens, and mothers have become expert scavengers. Their sense of smell is probably the best of all animals. And look what they've found. It's a bowhead whale, what's left of it. With unpredictable winter ice ahead, this bowhead carcass is a salvation for the family and for all the local polar bears. They will feed for weeks. Bowhead whales are increasing, maybe thanks to longer summers. Everything is changing, and everything is connected. There is regulated whale hunting here, and this carcass has actually been left on the beach for the wildlife. For the polar bears, it's a lifeline, but maybe little more. They are ice bears, evolved in another world. Across millions of years, the Earth has seen huge changes many times. The most recent was the end of the Ice Age, 12,000 years ago. This extraordinary wilderness protects these Ice Age survivors. The polar bears, muskox, Arctic foxes, and the spectacular caribou, holding out on the top of the world. Now, even for them, the Ice Age may finally be coming to an end.